Hello, my name is Adam Larrabee. I'm head of the guitar department at James Madison University School of Music, and I'd like to talk today about voicings for the B-flat blues. Some of these you may have already played, and some of them might be new to you, but there's a system that I like to work through using ninths and thirteenths, and what I call fat and high voicings, that hopefully will be helpful in terms of comping, not just on the B-flat blues, but blues in any key, or any standard that requires you to comp and add color to your chords. So let's talk about ninths and thirteenths first of all. A thirteenth is the same as the sixth degree of a scale. One, two, three, four, five, six. The sixth note of a B-flat scale. B-flat, C, D, E-flat, F, G. The sixth is the same as the thirteenth above the octave. So it generally replaces where the fifth would be, the note above the fifth. And the ninth, here's an E-flat 9 chord, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, is the same as the note above the octave, right? Octave means 8, so the ninth is really the same as the second degree of the scale. So by adding 13ths and ninths to my chord, I give them a little bit more color and a little more nuance, as opposed to just basic seventh chords. What you'll find in a B-flat blues is this voicing for B-flat 13, index, second, ring, pinky. Voice leads, meaning move stepwise to E-flat 9 very smoothly, both in terms of how far apart they are on the guitar neck and also in terms of the sound and how far apart the notes are from one another. So the first chord of a B-flat blues, the second chord of a B-flat blues. And what we'll play with today is that if I invert these, meaning play the B-flat as a ninth chord and the E-flat as the 13th chord, I found another position to start the blues form in. Meaning, if I start on the 13th chord, the next chord, E-flat, will be there, root on the 6th string for B-flat, root on the 5th string for E-flat. If I start with the B-flat root on the 5th string, my 4 chord, E-flat, will start with the root on the 6th string, so they invert. Also, a quick explanation about fat versus high voicings. Fat just means that the root's in the bass, and they have a slightly lower, thicker register. The high voicing takes the root out of the bass, in the case of the B-flat 13, off of the 6th string, and moves it up 2 octaves to the 1st string. So I'm actually just playing the B-flat here, but all of these notes are the same. You see the 6th fret, the 7th, and the 8th stay exactly the same. I've just changed what the top note is. So you can think of these as rootless voicings. I just call them high voicings. We're really just taking the root out of the bass and putting a note on the first string. In the case of the E-flat 9 chord, we take the root out of the bass and put that same B-flat in the top, which is going to be the fifth of the chord. So fat voicings of B-flat to E-flat, B-flat 13 to E-flat 9 is this, and high voicings are this. Can you see the similarity of the shape? I'm still seeing where the root is. I'm just not playing it. And that works the same way up here. The B-flat 9's high voicing takes the root out of the bass. And the E-flat 13's voicing. In this case, in order to have a common note with the B-flat, I actually put the ninth in the top of that one, right? As opposed to the root of E-flat, I'm putting the same note. So the B-flat 9 high voicing is this, and the E-flat 13th with a ninth added is this. So that's just an explanation how these chords invert. So let's go through these page by page, and I'd encourage you to combine them with the comping styles, especially the displaced Charlestons and the anticipations that we talk about in the jazz comping video. I've just written them here as whole notes and half notes, but I'll employ a little bit of rhythm as we go through to sort of show how those comping styles work. Here's B-flat blues number 1, starting on the 6th string, fat voicings, starting with the B-flat 13th. I'll start my metronome here. 1, 2, A 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's a diminished chord. Anticipations, 2 and 3 and 4, and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And here's B flat. Blues number 2, still fat voicings with a root in the bass, but starting on the 5th string root, the B flat 9. A 1, 2, 3, 4. Notice the inversion, B flat 13 to E flat 9, B flat 9 to E flat 13. So depending on what string you start the root on, the 9th and 13th chords flip. There's a lot of great 2-5-1s in here as well with some good voice leading. C minor 7th to F 9 has the same top note. So it's easy to play because they're nearby and also easy on the ears. Rather than moving from a C minor down here to an F7 up here, easy to play and well voice led for the sound of the notes in the chord as well. Let's move now to the high voicings. B flat blues number 3 and B flat blues number 4 are the same B flat 13s, but I have a circle, an open circle where the root is, showing that I see where it is, but I'm actually playing a 4-note voicing on the top strings here. B flat 13, E flat 9. I play it a bunch of different ways, using a little bit of a bar since that's familiar there. Then E flat 9. E diminished now is in an inversion, so the root's actually here. For our G7, remember we played a G7 flat 13. Well, I'm stretching up to get the sharp 9. There's still the bottom 3 notes, but I've changed the root a bit. Same thing with C minor 9, which was this or this. I've taken the root out of the bass and put this note on top. And the F13 also has a 9, the same note. Sometimes I'll finger that C minor 9 chord with my pinky on that note and this bar, my ring finger barring those 2 strings, so they don't have to move it. And then the turnaround. With the 9th, B flat 9, E flat 9, B flat 9. Here's E flat 9, E diminished, B flat 9. Remember, G7 sharp 9, which I did before, our sort of Jimi Hendrix chord. If I take the root out of the bass, the note on top is going to be the flat 13. Notice that the middle notes are exactly the same. I'm just taking the note out of the bass and putting a note on top. Going into C minor 9. That was the C minor 7th I used before. Here's the root because these are both E strings. Going up. And then the F13. Remember, that's an F9. Well, to keep a common note between C minor 9 and F13, I'm going to do that. And then my turnaround, the last 2 bars of the blues. And here it is with the metronome. I'll sort of use some free rhythms here so you can show how you mix up the comping rhythms. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. This is B flat blues number 3. Diminished. Number 4. So this should give you lots of ideas of how to play through a B-flat blues using lower fat voicings and higher voicings without the root in the bass. Sometimes I'd even go through and play low and high or high and low. Like, that's the Charleston rhythm going fat, high, fat, high, fat, high, fat, high. Or the other way around. High, low, high, low, high, low. So mixing up rhythms, mixing up fat versus high, mixing up positions, and alternation gives you lots of stuff to work on through a B-flat blues. I hope you have fun with these chords.